This astrophysics problem is quite advanced, but it's also really cool. The reason this problem is advanced is because the equation is pretty complicated in this problem, but there are some ways to make this equation a little simpler. The simple thing you can do is recognize that we have an eclipsing spectroscopic binary. Whenever this happens, this sine cubed I is going to go away. So to calculate the sum of the two masses of the stars, I'm going to start by plugging in the orbital period, which is 9.5 times 10 to the 7 seconds, or about 3 years. Star 1's velocity is 18 kilometers per second, and Star 2's velocity is 4 kilometers per second. And if I change the kilometers to meters, I'll have 22,000 meters per second as the added velocities, and the last thing I need is to plug in the denominator of this fraction. So we have 2, we have the approximate value for pi, and we also have Newton's gravitational constant, which is this number down here. So if you plug this entire number into a calculator, you should get a value of about 2.41 times 10 to the 30th kilograms, which is the total mass of the two stars combined.